So with Airheads, Adam Sandler, he was there. Brendan Fraser, what's that other guy's name from Sopranos? And
yeah, Steve Buscemi.
Yeah. They're like iconic actors. And what was it like seeing them play your characters that you wrote? And did you get to work with them when doing the film?
Yes, that was a unique experience because the director let me do everything. He let me sit in on casting and rehearsals and everything else and be on set as much as I wanted to, so that I was able to watch them work closely and make adjustments to the script and the dialogue to fit the actors. There's some times where you don't, like with The Dirt, the Motley Crue one, there's a scene that I see that I wrote, you know, 17 years ago, and I see it in the finished movie and I go, oh wow, you know, if I was there for the rehearsal, I would have changed that dialogue a little bit, right? So on the Airheads one, I had that experience of being able to be there the whole time. And, you know, it's like Sandler would say, well, what if we change it to this? I'm like, great, that's fine with me. That's hilarious. Let's do that. So working with them at that point in their careers, like Sandler was just still on Saturday Night Live. He was not a movie guy yet. That was tremendous. The same with Steve Buscemi. He had been in Reservoir Dogs. That's where we knew him from, but he hadn't been in big studio movies. And Brendan Fraser was like the biggest young actor on the planet. So that was just a very, very special, unique time. And it was the first time I got to see, you know, stuff that I had written on screen. And it's a trip when you write down the name of the radio station is KPPX, and the logo is a skull with a hat. And then you come to the set one day and somebody has built it, you know, exactly what you said it was supposed to be. Wow. And you walk around going, holy, this is crazy. It's very, very rewarding.
Yeah, I love Adam Sandler and his work. I'm sure there must have been a lot of improvisation on him because he was a comedian and things.
At that point, he didn't have the ability to do that. He wasn't a big enough star, and that was one of his first movies. So he would make suggestions or he would try things. But, you know, he was down here, the director and the studio were up here. Nowadays, he could do whatever. But at the time, it was pretty well scripted. I worked on his next movie. I don't know if you would know it. It's called Billy Madison.
Is that the one where he's like, he's rich and then he goes to primary school?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. That was the first movie he starred in. And I worked on that one with him and his writing partner for a little bit. I don't have a credit on it because I did very small amount of work. But I've worked with a lot of people that went on to be huge. I worked with Ben Affleck and Matt Damon and Matthew McConaughey and, you know.
On what projects were these?
They were all in one movie. I wrote and directed a movie that you cannot find called Glory Days. It's a little movie about a graduation weekend in college. And it starred Affleck and Sam Rockwell. And then there were small parts for Matt Damon, Brendan Fraser, Matthew McConaughey. It's like these amazing group of young actors who all went on to be huge movie stars. So it's really, really awesome when you get to work with somebody and know them from the first time, you know, really that they've starred in a movie or what have you. And a lot of people you work with are terrific and they don't have a career like Matt Damon, you know. It's so weird. You can be equally talented and one guy's career will go crazy and the other one won't. And, you know, there's so much luck involved. But it's really, really like Sandler, who thought he could have a career like that to last 30 something years. And he's still, now he's a dramatic actor and he's better than he's ever been.
Yeah. Uncut Gems was really good. Like he took that serious direction there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and it was a tiny, tiny little movie too. I was surprised that, you know, that he did it, and he did great.
Because you like worked with these actors at the beginning stage of their careers, do you think that you'd be able to like call up Ben Affleck, like say you have a script written and then you have like a character that you think he'd be good for. You think that you'd maybe like be able to still call him up, he and Matt Damon and...
No, I ran into Ben when he was doing Batman, when he was Batman, because he was all buff. I ran into him at the at a restaurant.
So yeah, he was huge.
Yeah. So I can say hi to him. I don't know how to get in touch with him. I would just have my agent call his agent. And because I worked with him, you know, early on, I'm sure they would read it. I don't know that he would read it, but his agent or his assistant or somebody would at least check it out. But I don't, you know, it's weird. You hope, I always see that, you know, like I worked with Sandler, I wish I was big friends with them, that I was still working with them now, but it doesn't work out. You just make friends like with any other job. Some people you hit it off with, some people you just have fun working with and then you never see them again. So I haven't seen any of those people ever again. I've worked many times with Vin Diesel. I've written at least 3 or 4 movies for him. And I guess that's the difference.
How is he like when you work with him?
Oh, he's super generous. He's super involved and enthusiastic. He doesn't have an attitude. He just, you know, I don't know. He's really smart. He knows exactly what he's good at and what his audience wants to see. And it's crazy because he is a mix of different races. Everybody can identify with him and see themselves. You know, he played an Italian guy in Saving Private Ryan. And then, you know, his dad is Dominican. He just has this look that everyone can go, oh, yeah, he could be in my family.
Yeah, you look like you could just find him. Like, he looked like you could find him in South Africa. Like, you'd just be there.
He's so in a gang movie. He's so popular around the world. Any country he goes to, that's why they had that cast in XXX3. They had an Indian actor and a Japanese actor and Chinese and people from all over I don't remember where that guy was from. He was Scottish or Irish. But because he's popular all over, they put in people from every continent. So, you know, it just made it more appealing to a global audience. So that's the final piece of advice. You do a short film like Vin Diesel that you star in and act in and get it to Steven Spielberg, and that'll be that.
I'll take that advice. So.
Catch full episodes of Into the Muse on Spotify, Anchor FM, and Apple Podcasts. Into the Muse on Spotify, Anchor FM.